welcome back to another episode of Dancing in the Kitchen with me, Janell. Today, because it's actually cold now in Los Angeles, I feel like making something kind of hearty in the kitchen tonight. So we're gonna make a lasagna, and in this case, it's gluten-free lasagna. And I was initially gonna make a mushroom lasagna, but then I changed my mind and decided to make a spicy mushroom and turkey lasagna. So we need, of course, a lasagna pan, some gluten-free noodles. These are great because you don't have to cook them. Mushrooms, parsley, garlic, cheese, turkey. I like the organic ground turkey. Are you ready to start cooking? So I have the oven preheating to 375 degrees, and I'm gonna try to do two things at once here. I'm gonna saute my onions and garlic. And you know, with the pandemic going on, I've been putting a lot of garlic and onions in food because they're a really good antiviral. So a little extra virgin olive oil, and then we're gonna add a cup of one onion, white onion chopped. And you know, you can put as much garlic in as you like. This is, I'm eating this myself. I think I've got 6 cloves of garlic in there, but I love garlic. Okay, so I'm gonna take that to the stove, and I'm just gonna stir that until it's iridescent. It's about 2 to 3 minutes. But at the same time, I'm gonna be multitasking and double stirring. I'm gonna cook my turkey meat because I don't wanna get any, I wanna get all the fat and everything drained off of it. So I'm just gonna cook that, and here we go. Might as well double trouble, right? I have to say, smelling the onions and garlic cooking is one of my favorite things. It just smells so good. Okay, so I cooked the turkey, and it's here, and I separated it. The onions and garlic have cooked down. They smell beautiful. In the same, I just wiped out the bowl from the turkey, and I'm gonna add the mushrooms. Now, I have about two like of those containers of mushrooms in here. I like mushrooms. So I'm cooking them separately because mushrooms have liquid in them. So if I were to throw this in, it would add extra liquid to the sauce. So I'm just gonna cook these down now on the stove. They don't even really need any oil or anything. All you have to do is stir them. And eventually, they just become thin little mushrooms. Mmm. Maybe I need a little bit of wine. Let's get this party started. I'm cooking the mushrooms. I don't know if you can see this, but there is so much liquid in here. So once they're done, this is a little bit longer, I'm going to strain them. Because I don't want all that broth. But mushroom broth in with my tomato, spicy tomato sauce. So that's why I'm cooking them separately. Okay, so the mushrooms have been cooked and I'm just still like straining them a little bit to get all the juice out. I washed them off. We've got our turkey. This is still hot. You can see in here how the garlic and the onions is cooked down nicely. So now to that we're gonna get our sauce ready. So we're gonna add the turkey. Make sure the liquid is all out of those mushrooms. One thing I really love about garlic is it's a really good antiviral, and with coronavirus and flu season and everything else, the more garlic you have in your system, the better. And I like it spicy, so I'm adding chili pepper flakes. Now, I think there's probably 2 heaping teaspoons in here, and I'm fine with that. Spicy senorita over here. Okay. Then I've got some organic crushed tomatoes. And I'm not sure if I'm gonna put all of these in. Let's see how big my sauce looks. Let's see. Because I don't want the sauce to be too runny. I'm gonna need a little bit more. You know what, I can always, I think I'm gonna use the whole thing. I can always though like, drain some of the sauce up when I go to put it into the lasagna. So I'm gonna get that on the stove and let that cook while we get our egg mixture, cheese mixture made. Okay, I'm gonna get this all warmed up and let it cook for a while so everything cooks in. Yeah, I definitely needed the whole, oh, that smells so good. The sauce is cooking. I'm getting thirsty. Okay, so you can use your cottage cheese in the middle, but my mom did this thing and I love it. So I'm gonna do the same thing for the inside part of my cheese mixture. I'm gonna take two eggs and beat them up. You get your violent tendencies out of the eggs. So just beat them up. And then we're gonna add some Parmesan cheese and some parsley. And it's gonna make a really interesting little cheesy insert to the inside of the lasagna. So I've got some chopped fresh parsley, I'm gonna add that. And then I have to add my Parmesan cheese. I'm thinking we'll start with a quarter of a cup. Let's see how that looks. Whoops, it looks messy how it looks. Now I definitely need more of the cheese. Too much egg in there. Actually, I'm gonna put the whole thing in. That was like, I already started that Parmesan cheese, so I'm just gonna mix it up. Actually, I think it's probably better if I just use a spoon than this thing, or fork or something. Mix it up now. That cheesy egg mixture is gonna go in the, doesn't that look pretty? It's gonna go into the lasagna. I wonder if I need a little bit more cheese. I think maybe I do. A little bit more Parmesan cheese. I just don't want it to be so gooey. So I have lots of Parmesan cheese. I love Parmesan. This one is a long, it's not as finely shredded, but it's still cheese. Tastes the same. We'll do the same thing. Sometimes you gotta improvise in life, right? A little improvisation. Okay, so that's better consistency. Okay, here's my cheesy insert. Ooh, that looks good. Okay, we're ready to make the lasagna now that I'm bringing. Ah, I just had a facial, a steam facial. Okay, so this is a no-boil noodle, meaning you don't have to boil it ahead of time. You can if you want, but I'm just gonna layer it down four across. Then we're gonna put some of the sauce on and spread that around. I'm just getting some of the extra liquid out as I do this because I don't need to. Okay, so I'm gonna spread the meat sauce out. So every little bit of the noodle is covered. Smells good. That maybe a little bit more. As it turns out, I'm gonna need all that sauce. Okay. Okay. Now I'm gonna take my eggy cheesy mixture here, and I'm gonna spread that on top. And spread it gingerly on top of that lasagna. So it's sort of all covering. It's also good, a fork is a really good thing to use just to kind of smudge everything around, okay? Parsley is also very good for you. Okay, now we're gonna put another, see how that looks? Another layer of the noodles. It's gonna be a thick lasagna. Okay. Another layer of the meat. I love Britney Spears music. It always puts me in a happy mood. Britney Spears, if you're listening, your music puts me in a happy mood. I'm glad you have your life back. Good for you. Well, it took long enough, huh? Well, I'm not gonna have as much. I guess I could have used more meat, but let's see. Okay, I'm gonna put the rest of the sauce on now. Not a sauce, the cheesy mixture. Okay. Let me spread that all around. Now, one more layer of the noodles. pour in the rest of this. You know, I don't think I'm gonna want, I feel like I'm not gonna have these noodles on the top. I think we've got enough noodles. I'm just gonna, there's too many noodles in here. I'm just gonna use this. And of course, we need mozzarella cheese. Not exactly a low-calorie dinner tonight, right? The party in the cold winter nights. So I'm gonna like line this with mozzarella. Gosh, I went to the store today, and I can't believe how much the prices have gone up in 2020. Like, this mozzarella used to cost like five, it's organic and all that good stuff, and used to cost me like, I think $5.80 or something, and now it's like almost $9. Like, that's the difference over the holidays. I don't know what's going on, guys, but the prices of food has gone up exponentially. So I will definitely be eating every bit of this. The good thing about lasagna, you can make it and it freezes really nice. So just put it in the freezer and then you're done. Okay, so here is my ready to go in the oven lasagna. And I've got it preset to 375 degrees. So just put a little tin foil over this and let it cook for 50 minutes. So you can go do something else in the next 50 minutes. I'm gonna do the dishes. And so put it in the oven for 50 minutes, and then take the foil off for the last few minutes boiling so it gets nice and crispy. So, hey everybody, so it's been an hour. The lasagna cooked, I took the tin foil off 10 minutes ago, and now it's been on the broiler for like 10 minutes getting crispy, and it's ready to come out of the oven. Oh, beautiful. Wow. Look at this gorgeous lasagna. It's hot, so I gotta let that cool down before I get into it. Anyway, it smells delicious. It's bubbly and hot and cheesy. Happiness in one pan. Anyway, happy wine, happy dancing in the kitchen with me, Janell. Happy wine always. Anyway, have a wonderful week.